Hello, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and a visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's That Celebrity Interview.
Good morning, Leila Lee and Dr. Bazin. How are you?
We're good.
Doing great. How about yourself?
I'm doing very good. I'm so excited to have you guys on to talk about children's eye health. And if I could start with you, doctor, if you'll set the medical understanding for us, then I'll talk to Leila.
Sure. Often parents will wait until the kids present a problem to them. And in fact, that we know that that's the wrong approach. We're huge advocates of getting kids in as early as 6 months to a year to make sure they have an annual comprehensive eye exam to ensure the health and vision of our kids' eyes. 80% of what our kids are learning is coming through their eyes, so it's very important that we know that they're healthy and performing top-notch. You know, because eye performance is in school is important. We also know performance on the field and in the sports arena is definitely important too.
Leila, we're going to switch to you. You're my hero. You are the daughter of the greatest. I was shocked to hear that you wore glasses at age 11.
I did, and that's why I partnered with Think About Your Eyes to encourage parents to get comprehensive annual eye exams for themselves and their children, because I didn't know, my mom didn't know, that you're supposed to take your kids to get their eyes exam at 6 months old, which is really surprising. So until, you know, I was 11, around the age of 11, I started having trouble seeing in class, couldn't really concentrate and focus, and my teacher brought it to my mom's attention, and then that's when she found out I needed glasses.
I know you've partnered with them, but you're a mom. Does this hit home for you?
It does, because I'm an advocate for health and wellness, and our eyes are directly related to our overall well-being. My daughter at 5 years old needed glasses, and I didn't know that because I didn't take her to get her eyes checked until, like, you know, you get the school exams, you think you got it covered, and then she started squinting in class, and her teacher told me she had to move her to the front, and I was like, oh my gosh. So I took her, get her eyes checked, and she needs glasses, so now we're both wearing them.
Dr. Bazin, is Layla's story kind of common? Because it hits home with me. Until they start squinting, you don't know.
Yeah, it's certainly super common. And in fact, parents are relying a lot of times on the pediatrician screenings or the school nurse screenings. And, you know, Layla's a perfect example of somebody who had passed school screenings and pediatrician screenings. And it wasn't until many years later that it was discovered that she had a problem that she needed glasses for. So I can't urge parents enough that school screenings are maybe a good start, but they are just covering one little portion of what we cover as eye doctors during a comprehensive exam. And even when they do discover or something, they're still missing 75% of vision problems. So parents, I urge you not to rely solely on the school screenings and the pediatrician screenings. Really use that thinkaboutyoureyes.com/locator feature on the website to find a great eye doctor and get your kids in and yourself in for an annual eye exam.
Okay, Leila, I want to ask you, you got glasses for your daughter. Was that easy for her? Because glasses are cool now. When I was growing up, they weren't cool.
They are, aren't they? And there's so many different styles, and you can really show your personality through your glasses. And I think it helps that I wear mine. I also wear contacts. But, you know, at first I thought, oh, I'm going to have to start really wearing glasses so that my daughter feels comfortable. She was comfortable without me wearing them. So that made it easier for me as a mom. But either way, whether she was or she wasn't, she was going to need to wear them, because what's most important is her eye health. And our eye health is, like I said, directly related to other issues. You can go to the eye doctor and find out that you might have diabetes or that you have heart disease. So there's other things that we need to think about. And our eyes are just a lot of times not one of those things we think we do until you have a problem. And you don't want to wait until you have a problem.
Okay. I want to ask you once again, it's almost time for back to school after summer. Will that be a part of your routine? People get, parents get soccer, you know, camp, physicals,
right,
all kinds of things. Do you put that on your list to make sure you get that in?
Summer is a great time to do it because our schedules kind of die down a little bit. The kids aren't in school. You don't have to take them out of school to go get their eyes examined. So you definitely want to make sure you get it done, and summer is a perfect time. But annually is the key because, like, for me, my eyes have changed over the years. When I started boxing, I needed glasses. I mean, I needed to get my vision correct so that I could see. Then as I got older, I went and got them checked, and I started having trouble driving at night. So here I am wearing glasses again. So you got to stay on top of it.
Okay, we're on top of it. I want to thank you guys for talking about this. I want to ask you a little bit. You've got a great new cookbook.
I do. It's called Food for Life, and it is my third baby. Put a lot of time and effort into it, and once again, it's all about health and wellness, trying to have people make their lives easier, eat healthier. So it's what you put in your body. It's taking care of your body. It really is a lifestyle.
Well, we want to get the book so we can look like you, if nothing else. Okay.
Please go do that. I promise you'll be looking just like me. I'm just joking.
Okay. Dr. Bazin, let me ask you, what about my parents? I just want to end with this question. What about my parents that have a hard time paying for all these visits? Is there anything to help them out?
Yeah, I think that most major insurances, and whether that's government or in the private sector insurances, do have a well vision benefit on there. And certainly if it's not a well vision benefit, at least the examination portion of the health of the eyes is covered. So for your copay, or sometimes even no copay. So don't let cost deter you. I think that if you just give the number on the back of your insurance card a call, you're going to be pleasantly surprised that you do have some type of coverage, because it is one of the most popular benefits that is provided from employers. So I encourage you to check the number on the back and give them a call and find out if you are covered. But most of the time, the answer is yes.
Okay. And also, I want my Facebook people are weighing in. They say people like the Shriner, the Lions Club, your local VA, they do provide some kind of support for that. So that's a good tip.
Absolutely.
Doctor, any place online my audience can go?
Yeah, thinkaboutyoureyes.com/locator is going to be able to provide you with a list of high-quality eye docs in your area.
All right. I want to thank you guys so much. This is an important subject. I'm sorry I kept you a little bit longer, but this is really important. Layla Ali, thank you for being my guest on the Valder Beebe Show. You are the greatest.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Have a great day.